गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग अभिनव। सो व्हाई अभिनव दिस फोटो इज सो क्लोज टू यू? When you switch off your camera, there's a photo of a tree.
Switch off the camera.
No. I'm talking to Abhinav. So when you switch off the camera, there is a tree, and under the tree there is a person sitting. Right.
Yes.
So Abhinav, what is the logic? What is the you can say why that photo is so important? Just asking, curious. Are you there, Abhinav? Okay, I think the third participant has not come, Harsh, because today is the toughest day. To listen is very easy, to speak
yes, sir.
Is tough.
Sir, what are you saying?
I was asking about whenever you yes, switch sir. Off your camera.
Yes, sir.
Then I see a tree. And then
where?
Whenever you switch off your camera, then after switching off the camera, I see a picture.
Like this.
Like this. Yes.
Yes, sir.
So what is the importance of this picture?
No, sir. In Zoom, it's asking for profile. So I set this profile because in WhatsApp, it's also my profile.
Okay. So you have chosen it at random. There's no logic.
No, sir.
Okay. So I always suggest anyone who is now frequent on Zoom that whenever your camera is off, try to select a photo, a professional photo. Professional photo means in a proper shirt and full pant if you are a male, and maybe a sari or salwar kurta for a female, and put on your profile so that if your camera is off also, you can see, everyone can see your professional photo. Like if I will switch off my camera, you can see. I have put a photo with my coat and all these things. It looks a bit professional. So in place of putting some tree and some person, try to click a nice photo of yours and keep it there. It gives a very nice, you can say, nice profiling. Nice profiling of your profile. Fine. So we'll start now. We will not delay much. So what was the topic? Who will announce for me the topic?
Today's topic is
topic of
debate.
Topic of group discussion. We are not doing debate. We'll go for group discussion.
Group discussion is the social media.
So what was the complete sentence?
Boon and curse.
So social media, boon or curse?
Curse.
What is the Hindi of this?
Sir, boon matlab wo sir vardan aur curse matlab srapit.
Abhishap. So social media hamare liye vardan hai ya abhishap hai? What I want from this discussion, I will also participate. I will also put forward my points, but I want both of you to give both parts, means both sides of the social media, where you feel that it is boon and where you feel it is a curse, and then also give some, you can say, some methods, some tricks so that we can have a nice control on social media and we can use it in a positive way. Means there are two things. One is that we will say that we have so much of problem because of social media. So just by telling problem is there, it is not going to be solved. So after telling it's a problem, also try to provide the solution. As per you, what is the solution so that we can use it also, we can keep it in control also, and we can get benefit out of it, right? So take a bit time, it's okay. You can think for 1 or 2 more minutes. But whenever you are going for group discussion, what is the positive side? What is the negative side? How we can create a balance? How we can control? And how we can take benefit from social media? Because nowadays, in this current scenario, in this current world, without social media, you cannot survive. If you are an adult, you are working in a company, you are teaching someone, you are in any, you can say, profession, without social media, you can't survive. So when we can't survive, it is very good for us to know its plus point and minus point and how I can keep a control on this, right? So I will suggest, I will request Radha ma'am to start. She will go first, then Abhinav will go second, and then I will go third. Then
sir, we
tell me,
sir. We sir, in both topic we have to say
both topic means. See, this is only
boon and curse. Boon and curse both.
I told you na that everything is having both parts, both sides. So I'm sure that you must be thinking in the same way, that it is having some advantages also and some disadvantages also. So it will be very, it's not a debate. Debate means you will go for one side. GD means you are going to give your complete know-how. Right, Abhinav?
So first
yes, sir.
You can start.
I will start with the good points. So social media, nowadays in this pandemic, social media is a boon for us. Everyone is sitting at home, and they have to maintain the distance, social distance, because this pandemic, it affected. If one is affected, if you touch in the person, other person, then whole family or whole area will be infected. So we have to maintain the social distance. So in this pandemic, this social media is a boon for us. Our people sitting at home, and the children at home, there is no ground, no friends, no any other children, they are at home, and all because of social media, they are engaged, mentally engaged. They are doing their work at home, work from home. And in the first pandemic, in previous year, the peoples are jobless. If the social media will not present, most of the people went into the depression. So if this all because of social media, most of the people are mentally fresh because they are entertaining through the social media. They are doing the job through the social media. The company who have to left out their employees, that you go, you can't stay here because this pandemic affect our life and spoil all things. So you have to go home. And if they need, because the work can't stop, the life can't stop. If they need a sudden help, they connect through the social media to their employees and take the benefit. And the person who gave the benefit to the company, they get something, they earn from the home. That is the boon for the social media. And the students, they are too much bored at home. They are but for maintaining their health, they are taking the good food, the energy level is high, and they are disturbing, and mentally and physically they do disturb the others. They are bored at home, they're playing the ball the whole day, mommy. They are only the wasting the time on the mobile or disturbing the parents, asking the first questions. And the students are so curious to know something. And if this is the time to turn the students through they turn the students their energy level in the right way. So all this time the social media plays a very good role, but at the same time, if the parents is not literate and the students are at the age of 9 to 13, 16, and they have a mobile, they financially they are strong, but they are not literate. Financially they are the middle class family, they can arrange by their best of income to the students that without mobile my children can't stay. They need the mobile for study, for connecting the things. They provide the mobile, and if they don't know how to operate the mobile, the student, the children then can take easily the bad benefit of the mobile. This way you can say, and the student are not spending their time on the study, and by the one click only they can go here to very far away. So this is the curse of the social media.
So there are three parts. One is the boon, second is the curse, and third is the remedy. What is the solution?
Solution, according to my knowledge, the solution is, if the parents are literate or parents are not literate, doesn't matter. My parents were not literate. My mother is not literate person. She is only understand the letters only. My mother. My father was spending the time in the company. Every day when I come from the school, my mother checked all my sister and brother's copy. Where is the sign in your copy? Why today's sign is not in the copy? Where is today's sign? What you have done in the school today? Where is today's date? If the date is written only on that one or two pages, they are finding the another page. You have in 7 period, you write only 2 pages. What you have done in the 7 period? In the 2 days, like continue, I am not going to school. I do not go to school. Then my mother said, "Why you are not going to school? What happened in the school? I'm coming to the school and ask your teacher what happened to her, to you. Why you are not like to go to school? What happened? Tell me fast." My mother is asking these type of questions. If I can study, if my mother is not a literate person, then nowadays I think. Now today's parents are in my age. It is not possible a parent is not literate. And the what I should say for the generation. Today's generation is so fast. The things is around us is so fast. If you are not by any chance the parents unable to study that time in their own time, maybe something problem were there, then things around us is very fast, going very fast. Automatically we learn something from the our surroundings. So they should be attentive, watch their children every day with their diary, books, their personality means their living style. What they are using, why they are scaring when parents enter into the house. If they are,
if parents enter and they become shocked, surprised.
Shocked or alert.
Alert.
Yes.
Then there is something wrong going on.
Then when students were not at home, the parents should check each and everything related to the student. Then automatically they will find the problem, what problem is going with the students, and they can talk friendly with the children. What happened? Tell me. I am your great friend. I can solve your problem. I am for everything. Tell me the reason what you can share with your friend. I can, or you can share those things to me also. I will not feel bad. If something already you have done wrong, I will not feel bad. I will give you the reason, I will give you the solution, what you should, this time you should do, and I am with you. Just trust me, but I am with you. That is the, and if the children is little more small, just that like a Nilesh, then that student you can handle easily. You can talk, play with them, keep attention on their homework. That is the redeeming of this.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Now it's time for Abhinav to speak on this topic. Unmute yourself.
Abhinav, your sound is not coming.
Introduce myself. My name is Abhinav Arya, and I am going to tell a topic on internet. Is a boon or internet is a boon or curse? First I tell topic on boon. In this 21st century, the most of the computers, laptops and internet come in this field. We use computers, laptop in online shoppings, in banks, in post office and in many areas to do our work easy. And in this time, the network is very useful thing to connect with us family, friends and other family friends in this, especially during this pandemic. In this pandemic, we use online teaching or other people use online jobs to maintain their family. In whenever we go to mall, they give us bill electronically. Without electronically, they have to write with their pen, and so many customers they have to write with their pen, and with electronically they have to just touch their keyboards, and then the bill come out. And by this, the biggest thing in this pandemic is online shopping. With online shopping, we can order anything, foods, items, etc. by our mobile, laptops, instead of going outside in this pandemic. Answer, curse. So curse, in curse. In curse, the curse is the curse of internet is when sir, धोखाधड़ी को क्या बोलते हैं इंग्लिश में सर?
Cheating.
Yes, sir. In this time, many users can cheat with us with bank. They all withdraw our money. This is the bane of internet. In internet, they give us fake news and we believe on it. Like they say there in this city there is. The flood come and we don't go by there. Whenever this is a shortcut and we have to go through long cut. This is the bane of internet. Done, sir.
Okay, so I think Abhinav has not prepared well. So simple, because we have to discuss on social media, and he is more talking about online shopping and all the tools which we use for shopping in the mall and all. Social media basically is what? Social media is basically your Facebook, your Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube. So all those places where you can connect with others, and either you can share, you can like, you can comment, you can chat, you can message. Means digitally, if you can socialize, the word is socialize. If you can socialize digitally, all those platforms are called social media platforms. So suppose if my friend is in US, But with the help of Facebook, I can keep in touch. I can know what he is doing, where he is going in vacations, right? How is his family? How many children? Where he works? So everything I can know through the social media platforms. Now, as far as my memory goes, this social media in India, it started gaining importance in 2007, 2009. Why I say that? Because those years I was in Pune, and I think 2008, I first came to know about Facebook. Till that time, Facebook was not so famous, not everywhere. And data also was very costly. To have a phone, a smartphone was tough. Smartphone was costly. And then data was very, very costly. So either you can use Facebook in office with the help of office internet, or you can go to a net cafe and use it. So there were many challenges at that time. But slowly what happened, 2G, then 3G came, then 4G came. And recently, the moment this Jio came, and Jio slashed the rate of this data, then there was a big problem. Means big problem is in the sense that now everyone can use data easily. It is very cheap now. Fine. And after Jio coming into picture, and then this lockdown happened. Everything became online, working from home. All kids are studying online. So everything went online. And what Radha ma'am was telling was correct only, that if you want to engage yourself or your kid when they are spending the entire time in the house only, then you